Let us simulate two PV cells in series. Let us take the case of two identical PV cells in series. I have captured the circuit in a GSM schematic, and this is the schematic. This part here is one PV cell and this is another PV cell. So I have named this one as PV cell 1. It is having the insulation source, the current source 1 amp. There is a diode D1 and a shunt resistance and a series resistance. Likewise, for PV cell 2, there is an insulation current source IP2, 1 amp, same value, D2 and R shunt and R series come into the picture. So this cell is connected in series to this, and the terminals where the load is connected is across at this point, where we have connected a voltage source, which is a sine varying source, which is supposed to provide the x-axis sweep. I have named the node as NVT for the output terminal, NVT2 for the terminal which measures the terminal voltage for cell 2, the bottom cell. If you have to find the terminal voltage for the top cell, which is the PV cell 1, it is NVT minus NVT2. I have included here the spice include directive. The file is pv.sub. In that one, inside that one is a diode model, default diode model, which is supposed to handle these two diodes, D1 and D2. So now we are ready with the schematic. Let us generate the netlist and simulate using ngSpice. Let me go to the simulation project folder, which is PVSim. There are three files that you will see here. Series.sch, this is the schematic file that we just now saw. Series.cir, this is the circuit file which contains analysis. PV.sub, which was referred in series.sch through the spice directive. This contains nothing but the diode model, default diode model. Series.cir actually has the transient analysis statement and an include statement for including the netlist, series.net, which we have not yet generated. We will just do that now. There is a series of control statements. One is to set the background as white and to set the foreground as black, then the run command. So that is put into the control statement. Now let us generate the netlist file and then go into ngSpice. For that, first open the terminal window, go to the project subfolder. So we have all the relevant files here. I have here the netlist generation command, gnetlist minus dash g spice dash sdb output to series.net from the input series.sch. So this will generate the netlist. You can come back here and see that the netlist is generated, and then now call ngSpice series.cir. So we are in ngSpice. ngSpice has used the run command, which was there in the dot control statement. You can check the display and see that these are the vectors available for you to plot. Now we can plot and see the results. What is it that you would like to plot? You could open the schematic file so that it becomes a bit more easy for you to understand the variables that you are plotting. Now let us say we would like to plot the current through this output source, that is I, and the node voltage across this, that is the terminal voltage. How does it look like? So let us plot current V naught through the V naught source versus NVT. So we get a plot out like this. So rather than seeing a single plot, we can see a group of plots which will give you a kind of a relative idea of the various things. So let me quit this. Let us plot the I versus V characteristic of the PV cell 1, PV cell 2 and the overall cell. Plot IV naught versus NVT would give you the I versus V characteristic of the overall resultant PV module, and then IV naught versus NVT 2 would give you the IV characteristic of the PV cell 2, and IV naught versus NVT minus NVT 2 would give you the IV characteristic of PV cell 1. Now plot that, you will get this. Maximize that, then you will see that you have this characteristic. You see this line, the blue line, actually this is having two lines. One is the orange and the other one is the blue. This is I versus V for the two cells. They are identical cells, and the red one is for the resultant cell, and that's what you are seeing here, which matches with our theory. Now let us plot the power versus voltage curve for the three items, which is power versus voltage for cell 1, power versus voltage for cell 2, and then for the combination. So let us say plot IV naught. The I current is same for all, because they are connected in series, same for all the three components, into, I'll say, NVT for the overall cell versus NVT, and the next plot will be IV naught into NVT2 for the PV cell 2 versus NVT, the same x-axis, IV naught into NVT minus NVT2 would be the voltage across cell 1 versus NVT. So this will give you the power versus voltage curves for the three cells. You see them here. So you see that the blue one, power versus voltage for cell 1 and also cell 2, orange superimposed, and the red curve is the power versus voltage curve for the series combination. I have here the circuit of two modules connected in series. Now this is module 1. This module 1 contains 5 PV cells. And these 5 PV cells are identical, all having 1 amp insulation current sources. They are connected in series. And there is another module, module 2, and they are also connected in series. Not all are identical. You have 2 of them having 1 amp current source and 3 of them having 0.7 amp current source, indicating that these PV cells have partial shading. Now this module 2 and this module 1 are connected in series to the external load. In this case, the external load is this voltage source, which is acting as a sweep. If you look at the simulation project folder, you have 3 familiar files. Series.sch is the schematic file which we just now saw. Series.cir is the circuit file which contains the analysis statements. And pv.sub contains the diode model, the default diode model in this case, which is referred in series.sch through the SPICE include directive. Now if you want to have a look at series.cir, I have here the transient analysis statement, and there is an include statement which includes the series.netlist file. This is the netlist file which we will generate shortly. And there are these control statements, where the first two are to set the background as white and black, and then run. You will run the simulation automatically. Then plot. So plot I versus V, I versus I into V. So this is the power versus V, power of the combined system versus V, power of module 1 versus V, power of module 2 versus V. I have scaled I versus V so that you have a much more nice looking graph. So now going to the terminal window, let us generate the netlist first. We execute this. We see now that there is a netlist which has come in, and now we call ngspice series.cir and execute that. You see that it has executed, and then you maximize the graph, you will see all the graphs that we had included in the control statement. Now look at these. I, that is the current flowing through the external load, so that is this red line, versus V, and this orange line is I into NVT minus NVT2, which is the voltage across module 1. So this would be the power of the module 1, which is the orange line. This is the orange line. And the green line is the power of module 2. That is this, the one which is weaker and has partial shading. And the green one is the net power of the combined cells. So you see that it agrees very much with the discussion that we have had previously. Observe that module 1 is always in quadrant 1, which is sourcing throughout. Observe that the green line crosses from sourcing to sinking at this point. So here all these places the power is positive, module 2 is acting as source, here the power is 0 and it crosses over, power becomes negative, and here it is sinking, it is acting like a dissipator. Now let us see what happens if we put the protective diode and try to remove this portion, this negative portion of the power. This is the same circuit of two modules connected in series. There is one modification that I have made, and that is this diode. I have included this bypass diode here to protect module 2 whenever module 2 tries to go negative, that is operating in the sync mode. Now let us go to the terminal. Let us now generate the netlist, and now let us go to ngspice and go into its environment.cir. You will see that the simulation is executed, and you see now this set of graphs along with the protection diode. Observe that the green line, which is the power curve of module 2, and as it tries to go negative, it gets clamped. Of course, the diode is not ideal, so it gets clamped to the forward voltage. Observe also the shape of this curve. It is as per our discussion. Observe that the power curve for the entire system, series system, is having two bumps, and it is not a single hill or single bumped power curve.